Supposing we hit the body with a tremendous, whether it's ultraviolet or just very powerful light, and I think you said that hasn't been checked, but you're going to test it. And then I said, supposing you brought the light inside the body, you can, which you can do, either through the skin or in some other way. And I think you said you're going to test that, too. Sounds interesting.
We'll get the right folks who could.
Right. And then I see the disinfectant, where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning? Because you see it gets on the lungs and it does a tremendous number on the lungs. So it'd be interesting to check that. So that you're going to have to use medical doctors with. But it sounds interesting to me.
Former President Donald Trump, he's only 3 years younger than President Biden. But it's an issue for voters, President Biden's age. And Donald Trump has gone right ahead mocking the current president over it.
So he's totally incoherent. And he goes, thank you.
Okay, here's the thing though. Trump himself, not immune to making mistakes that could be attributed to his age.
Well, thank you very much, and a very big hello to a place where we've done very well, Sioux Falls. Thank you very much, Sioux Falls. And so, Sioux City, let me ask you. You know, I was very honored as a man, Viktor Orban. Did anyone ever hear of him? He's probably like one of the strongest leaders anywhere in the world. And he's the leader of, right? He's the leader of Turkey.
Notably, Viktor Orban, not the leader of Turkey. He is the prime minister of Hungary.
Story, a quick story. You don't mind if I go off teleprompter like a lot, do you? So much more exciting. So much more. But the head of Hungary, a very tough, strong guy, Viktor Orban. Did anybody ever hear of him? Probably, you know, considered very powerful, very powerful within his country and outside of his country. Not exactly loved by some of the European nations because he does his thing. He didn't allow millions of people to invade his country. He allowed nobody to invade, zero. He had nobody. So he doesn't have crime and he doesn't have the problems that they're having in other countries where millions of people are allowed to go in. But they were interviewing him 2 weeks ago and they said, what would you advise President Obama? The whole world seems to be exploding and imploding. And he said, it's very simple. He should immediately resign and they should replace him with President Trump, who kept the world safe. And I'm not just talking the United States. China respected him. Russia respected him. North Korea respected him. And he used another word other than respect to, he said fear, but I don't want to use that word. Of course, it's probably better than respect if you get right down to it, right? But he said everybody was fine. We had none of these problems. You didn't have inflation. You didn't have these problems 3 years ago. And then you look at this, we had the greatest economy in history. Now we have a mess. You'll end up in the Great Depression. And I'll tell you the one thing I don't want to be. I don't want to be Herbert Hoover. I always said, I don't want to be Herbert Hoover. And the way they're going with their stupid energy policies, you know, you pay the highest in this state. You pay the highest energy costs anywhere in the United States. You know that?
When President Trump arrived on stage,
I'm thrilled to be here.
Here wasn't where he first said he'd appear when he tweeted in the morning that he would be addressing the Farm Convention in Nashville, Tennessee. Love our farmers, love Tennessee, a great combination. Great, but wrong. The convention was in New Orleans, Louisiana. The tweet was deleted. Pesky geography, so many countries to get wrong, twice.
Nambia's health system.
It took others to catch President Trump's mistake when he toured the fire-ravaged community of Paradise, California.
And what we saw at pleasure. What a name right now.
Unfortunately, the wrong name.
Oh, we just left pleasure.
Paradise.
We're paradise.
But there's one place no U.S. president could possibly mess up, right?
And God bless the United States.
We start in Iowa, we go to New Hampshire, we come down here. You know, the beauty was when I came here, everyone thought Bush was going to win. And then they took a poll and they found out Trump was up by about 50 points. Everyone said, what's going on right here? They thought Bush, because Bush supposedly was a military person. Great. You know what? He was a military. He got us into the Middle East. How did that work out? Right. But they all thought that Bush might win. Jeb. Remember Jeb? He used the word Jeb. He didn't use the word Bush. I said, you mean he's ashamed of the last name? And then they immediately started using the name Bush. Never forget it.
We are also praying for the people of Puerto Rico. We love Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico.
We love you.
And we also love Puerto Rico.
We have a man who is totally corrupt and the worst president in the history of our country. Who is cognitively impaired, in no condition to lead, and is now in charge of dealing with Russia and possible nuclear war. Just think of it. We would be in World War II. Our leading political opponent, and leading by a lot, including Obama. I'll tell you what, you take a look at Obama and take a look at some of the things that he's done. This is the same thing. The country is very divided. And we did with Obama. We won an election that everyone said couldn't be won. We want every American child to have access to pristine outdoor spaces. When young Americans experience the breathtaking beauty of the Grand Canyon, when their eyes widen in amazement as Old Faithful bursts into the sky, when they gaze upon Yosemites, towering sequoias,